What you gonna do with all that junk in outer space? Hey space junkies, Julian here for DNews. Space is more accessible than ever, and we're launching new stuff up there all the time. But along with all the satellites and space stations, we've also left a lot of litter in our wake. And if it hits anything, it'll create more junk and quickly get out of control. To help keep track of all that junk, NASA monitors the biggest pieces and actually publishes a newsletter called Orbital Debris Quarterly. That's right, NASA talks about space junk as much as we talk about gentlemen. It's like a tabloid for space geeks. It even ranks the top 10 satellite breakups of all time. But why just keep track of it? Why don't we go up there and take out the trash? I mean, there have been some proposals and experiments. As far back as 1996, the space station Mir attached pieces of gel to the outside to gather microscopic space junk, though the results were negligible, ruling it out as a trash collection service. Other ideas have been suggested, like launching other satellites to grapple onto derelict ones and hauling them back down to Earth like a professional wrestler doing a Batista bomb. The Swiss EPFL's Clean Space One was drawn up to grab Switzerland's first satellite, Swiss Cube, and remove it from orbit. How do you like that? They send up one tiny cube and they still want to go and clean it up. Way to go, the Swiss. But their solution can't capture debris that's very large or very small. But the ESA is also working on something to take large satellites down by 2021. Like the Swiss space Roomba though, it's a one-shot deal. In 2014, Japan's space agency actually tested out a metal space net designed to create a magnetic pull to drag floaty bits out of orbit. They hope to have something ready by 2019. Ideas that don't require sending something expensive into space expensively have also been dreamed up. In 2012, Raytheon tested phase one of their space debris elimination concept. The idea was a device suspended by balloons 80 kilometers up would shoot a jet of atmosphere as high as 600 kilometers. When junk hits the suddenly thick air, it loses speed and comes back down to Earth. Raytheon concluded that while the energy costs were high, they weren't unreasonable and could possibly be reduced with further development. And of course, there's everybody's favorite idea, space lasers. Yes, space lasers. Sure, we could put them on other satellites to give them a clean path, but that's a space law no-no because now you've started weaponizing space. Even putting them somewhere neutral like the ISS is dicey because that's how you get rogue supervillain astronauts. Instead, if we're going to have what NASA boringly calls the laser broom, it would have to be stationary on Earth, and this means you'd have to target fast-moving tiny particles hundreds of kilometers away and pepper them with laser bursts in just the right way to unsettle their orbit and bring them tumbling down. No easy feat. Plus, it's imperative that the laser doesn't miss and damage something we actually need that's further out in space because the laser beam just kept going. Makes you wonder what happened to all those shots that missed when X-Wings and TIE fighters tangled. Now, technically, we don't have to do any of this. All objects circling the Earth will experience orbital decay, eventually crashing back down here on their own. Given enough time, space will clean itself, but it'd be nice to have some control over where all that heavy debris lands, and not to have to wait decades or even centuries for gravity to decide. Right now, the cost and challenge of cleaning up space isn't really worth the effort. Space is still a pretty big place, and the odds of collisions are slim. But if satellites do start colliding, then space junk will multiply, and the problem will get out of hand fast. If it gets to that point, hopefully one of these technologies will be ready to clear a path, and hopefully it won't be the laser broom. So, say we make these technologies to knock space junk back down towards Earth. Then what? Trace and Amy talk about dropping space balls here.
Everything currently orbiting Earth will eventually make its way back down, and there is a lot of stuff orbiting the Earth.
According to NASA, there are more than 22,000 pieces of space junk 10 centimeters or larger orbiting our planet, right alongside tens of millions of smaller pieces.
What proposal's your favorite? Is it the lasers? It's the laser broom, isn't it? Isn't it? Well, let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.